Welcome to our live training session number 39. We're going to learn how to tune a turbocharged Honda S2000 using AEM Series 2 engine management. Let's jump into some details about this vehicle. We're going to find it has the original bone stock F22C engine that Honda fitted to this AP2 chassis. It's going to have a custom turbo kit using a BorgWarner S366 turbo. It has a 3-inch turbo back exhaust, dual tile 38mm wastegates, a tile blow-off valve, large front mount intercooler, so the kit is all custom for this application. Now it also has, on the fuel system side of things, ID 1000cc injectors, an upgraded aftermarket fuel rail and fuel pressure regulator. In addition to that, it has a Walbro 450 liter per hour fuel pump. The fuel pump has been rewired with thicker gauge wire, so the power and ground wire, through a aftermarket relay so that the fuel pump receives the proper voltage, so we have proper fuel pump performance as our fuel flow rate increases as we get into boost. Now it also has a 3-port boost solenoid that we're going to be controlling through the Series 2 EMS. It has an AEM failsafe wideband gauge we're going to be using for closed loop control and lean protection, which we're going to be covering. And it also has a AEM 3.5 bar map sensor that obviously we need so that when we get into boost, it's going to be registering boost properly. So we're going to be doing all of our tuning here on 93 octane. We're going to have a lot to cover. So let's jump into our live training series here so we can begin creating our base calibration and get our engine fired up. Welcome to our live training session here with our turbocharged AP2 Honda S2000. Now we just went over all the details of the vehicle. Let's jump into our AEM Tuner software so we can begin creating our base calibration file to start off our live training series with. So jumping into our AEM Tuner software, we need to actually open up a file. Right now, if we look in any of our tabs here in our layout, we see that they're all blank because we haven't actually loaded a calibration file here to start to work from. So what we're gonna have to do is go into our C drive, into the directory, in the folder that installs when you actually install your AEM Tuner software. There's a default folder that's gonna contain all the different base calibrations for the different plug and play applications we're gonna work with. In this case, we have a 6052 box, that's the part number from AEM, which is gonna be associated with the 2000 to 2005 AP1, AP2, S2000. Now 06 and later had a different part number. That's going to be, I believe, a 6053. So right now we are going to look for that 6052 base calibration file. We're going to be making all of our editing changes to that based on the modifications we have on this car in this video. And then the next subsequent videos, we're going to go through the calibration process of dialing everything in so you know exactly what to do if you're going to be tuning an S2000 with AEM Series 2. So let's jump in here. I'm going to go to File. I'm going to go to Open. That's going to allow me to open a calibration. We're going to go into our C drive here so we can see the local disk C drive. We're going to specifically look for our program files x86, and then here under the AEM folder, we're going to move into the AEM Tuner folder. Now in here, we're going to be looking for the calibrations folder, double-click AEM updates, and then we're going to find here we have a couple different marks of cars that we might want to be interested in looking for the base calibrations file. So in this case, it's going to be Honda that we want to choose. And then we're going to find grouped in order all the different part numbers and base maps associated with those part number boxes. So in this case, again, we have a 6052. We're going to find the 6052 option here or here. We can choose these to start with. Now this 6052 option is going to be a supercharged application. This is turbocharged, so it might be tempting to use this. I'm going to use this 6052 AP2 naturally aspirated base map because we're going to be essentially going in and doing everything ourselves and creating that base calibration. It's going to be a little bit more work, but well worth it. After you go through all this training course, you're going to be seeing all the steps associated with this. You can replicate it on your own vehicle. So I'm going to grab this option right here. We're going to click Open, which is going to open it up in our actual AEM Tuner software. Now we can see if we click in our different tabs, we have that file open here. We can start making our editing changes. So we have a lot of things to go in and edit and work with. Now, what I typically do just to get things started, I'm going to go and save this file as a different name. That's really important. We can see up top here, it's going to show us the directory where it's saved, and we can see 6052S2000 AP2.02VO2.CAL. So this is the actual file. If I simply go here to File, and then I go Save Calibration, if I actually make an editing change, let's move this up here, just hit plus a couple times and make a quick change here. We're going to see we can do a save calibration or a save as calibration. We want to do a save as at this point because we don't want to oversave on top of this base file if we want to start with this again for another application. Otherwise, the only way to obtain this file is to reinstall your AEM Tuner software, which doesn't really make any sense. So let's go here and just take care of this and do a file save as. And that's going to force us to go in and find a directory we want to go and save this to. So I'm going to go in here to my documents. I have an AEM folder started already. Now, right now, I have an AEM data and Infinity Tuner. I'm going to create an AEM
Tuner.
Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.